Yeah, man.
Keep reading, right?
Yeah, go back.
All right.
They're showing you that Jake had that sellout spirit way back then, man.
It says, "For since we departed from them, we have had much sorrow. So this device pleased them well. Then certain of the people were so forward herein, they went to the king who gave them license to do after the ordinances of the heathen."
Yep.
"Whereupon they build a place of exercise at Jerusalem according to the customs of the heathen."
Hey, and what was that place of exercise? What is the place that we go to today to get our exercise on? The gymnasium.
Gym.
That's a Greek word. That's why when you go to the gym and you go to the locker room, people are naked. Because the word gym goes back to the Greek word gymnos, and which means naked.
They're damn near naked in there.
That's
like all the tight form-fitting clothes.
Yeah,
that's why when you go back to the Sulaki, bro, when you go back to the Greek and Roman art, a lot of it is the human figure, the naked body.
Naked bodies, man.
Yep.
That Renaissance art.
They in, yep.
They always showing you Adam and Eve butt naked.
Yep.
The angels is butt naked.
Covering their pride.
Some of them, they don't even have a leave.
The idols that they worship, like Hercules and Zeus and all them, they were always butt naked with wings, man.
If you zoom in, Sulaki, if you zoom in, you can see. And these are censored down for children.
Those are Roman idols over there.
Right. But it extended
which really the Greeks were worshiping them first.
Right.
And then the Romans took
them
on,
right on up.
And picked them up and renamed them because their language was Latin, you know?
Anyway, keep going. It's a little more. It says, "And made themselves uncircumcised and forsook the holy covenant and joined themselves to the heathen and were sold to do mischief."
Read that verse one more time, bro.
Come on, it says,
"This is how our people became uncircumcised and became Gentiles." Right?
These were the willing ones right here.
Yeah, they were willing. They did it because they didn't want to be put to death.
Right, no, I'm going to jump down to the one that was unwilling too. It says, I'm going to read up real quick. It says, "In those days there went out of Israel wicked men who persuaded many, saying, let us go." It said, "In those days there went out of Israel wicked men who persuaded many, saying, let us go and make a covenant with the heathen that are round about us. For since we departed from them, we have had much sorrow." Jumping down to 15, it says, "And made themselves uncircumcised and forsook the holy covenant and joined themselves to the heathen and were sold to do mischief."
Yep.
Now I'm going to jump down to verse 41. Yeah, it says, "Moreover, King Antiochus wrote unto his whole kingdom that all should be one people."
That's that new world gathering everybody all together, man.
To the Tower of Babel.
Like the Tower of Babel. He took that concept from ancient Babylon. All right, and that same concept, that same philosophy is right here today. That's why you got all these different nations gathered here in this melting pot.
Right, that sounds world citizens.
Yeah.
Citizen of the world.
Yeah. Yep.
You know?
Verse 42. "And everyone should leave his laws, so all the heathen agreed according to the commandment of the king."
So they agreed, Jake, at the that heathen. Time, they agreed with the heathen. They came together with those Greeks, those Edomites.
Yep.
All right? They subscribed to the philosophy of in pluribus unum.
Yep. Out of many one.
Out of many one.
Yep.
Right?
That's Latin.
Go ahead, bro.
Verse 43 said, "Yea, many also of the Israelites consented to his religion."
Just like Israel consent to that ideology today.
Yep.
All right, Jake wanted to be accepted by everybody.
Good.
Why can't everybody be together? Why can't everybody be saved?
An example, G-Man.
Yeah, G-Man, you would have been one of these guys, man.
You probably were.
You don't believe in keeping the law. You teach that plantation Christianity.
Yep.
You know, you don't have a beard on your face when you know you can keep a beard. Hey, when they was under the Greeks, they wasn't keeping their beards.
Yep.
That was a Greek custom to not wear your beard on your face.
Right.
Right?
Chapter 43 again says,
go ahead.
Yea, many also of the Israelites consented to his religion and sacrificed unto idols and profaned the Sabbath.
And they were, Jake was profaning the Sabbath,
yeah.
You know? But basically the point, the brother already read it, this is what made Israel uncircumcised to the Heavenly Father.
Still more.
Okay? So that's how you get an understanding on the circumcision and the uncircumcision in the New Testament. When you read Ephesians, the second chapter, that's what that's talking about, man.
Let me read a little more, man.
Go ahead.
Verse 48. I'm gonna go one way and come right back. Look how confused this place is. The ambulance went one way, then they turned around and went right back the other way. Anyway, it says, verse 48, it says, they should also leave their children uncircumcised and make their souls abominable with all manner of uncleanness and profanation, to the end that they might forget the law and change all the ordinances. And whosoever would not do according to the commandment of the king, he said, he should die.
See that? So they were forcing Jakes to become Greeks. They forced them into it, man. And you had wicked Israelites that were willing, and then you had Israelites that were willing to be martyrs for Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, man. You had, just read the book of Maccabees.
If I read down, it jumps to the point.
It tells you, you have the Maccabees brothers was raised up. You had different men who were upstanding men who were willing to die for the laws of the Heavenly Father.
Right.
Okay, they refused to sell out.
Right.
You know?
So
going back to the New Testament, man, let's go back to where it talks about the Gentile.
Okay, come. I'm going to start at 14. You can get that in the blue letter. It says, for when the Gentiles, which have not the law, do by nature the things contained in the law. Hey, why they seem to be in the temple, right? Hey, did we read earlier that the heathen won't do righteousness, right? But these Gentiles are still doing the things contained in the law, which is righteousness. So does that make them still Gentiles or heathen? No, those are Israelites. It says, do by nature the things contained in the law, these having not the law are a law unto themselves, but show the work of the law written in their hearts, their conscience also bearing witness, and their thoughts the meanwhile accusing or else excusing one another.
That's right, man.
So look up that word.
This is Gentile in blue letter. It's Strong's G. 1484, the word is ethnos, a multitude, whether of men or of beasts, associated of living together, a company, troop, swarm, a multitude of individuals of the same nature or genus.
That's the key point, or genus of those that kept the law, the gene of those that kept the law, when you put it in the context of that scripture. They did what contained in the law, even though they didn't have the law. It was the law written in their hearts.
The human family, a tribe, nation, people, group, in the Old Testament, foreign nations not worshiping the true God, pagan Gentiles, but that's talked about.
But what you had Israelites that was doing that, they were worshiping pagan gods.
Yep.
You know, they became like the Gentiles, man.
Yep. We
read the history on it, but you gotta know how to discern and differentiate when it's talking about the Israelites and when it's not.
That's why I read that one, because they were doing the things contained in the law, and we already brought the scriptures out that they, what if you to take the statutes in my mouth?
Hey, you know, get Romans 12 and 1 now. Or was it 1 Corinthians 12? I believe it's 1 Corinthians 12.
Yeah, 1 Corinthians.
1 Corinthians 12. So you Edomites, you can't use the Gentile angle either. We're cutting that angle too. Okay?
Right here. 12:1. That's the last thing you got.
1 Corinthians 12:1.
It's 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 1. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren.
He called them brethren.
Yep.
My brothers. Right? Go ahead.
I would not have you ignorant. Ye know that ye were Gentiles carried away.
Hold on, hold on.
Yep.
You were Gentiles.
Yep.
How could you used to be a Gentile if you were already a Gentile in the first place?
If you're a heathen, how could you used to be?
Right.
Right. And now you're not. Now you're my brother.
You see that?
But they're going to tell us that because Christ died. No.
No. And matter of fact, go to 1 Corinthians 1. Let's see what Apostle says when he addresses the people of the church of Corinth. What does he call them? 1 Corinthians 1 and 1 through 2.
You got it.
And then jump back to 12 and 1.
1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 1. Paul, called to be an apostle of Yahushua HaMashiach, through the will of the Most High, and Sothenes, our brother, unto the church of the Most High, which is at Corinth, to them that are sanctified in Yahushua HaMashiach, called to be saints.
We broke that down already. Yep.
You should already know who that's talking about. Now that we understand that he's addressing the church of Corinth and calling them to be saints, go back to 12. Yep.
That you're now, basically he's about to say that you're now the saints, but you were once Gentiles. Because you were the saints before you became Gentiles, that's why we broke that down in the history.
Start at the point.
Okay,
two.
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 2. Ye know that ye were Gentiles carried away unto these dumb idols, even as ye were led.
You were carried away unto dumb idols, even as you were led. That's what happened to Jake, man. And guess what? That goes back to the curses.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Didn't I say that he was gonna scatter us, and we were gonna serve the idols that we knew not, wooden stone. You know, that's what happened, man. So therefore, the Lord he dispersed us through the countries.
Yep.
You know.
All the other nations.
Hey, what does it say? Is it Hosea? Let me see real quick, man.
Yeah, Hosea, not my people.
That's one.
I'm trying to think what you are.
Hosea, one in...
No. Hosea, I believe, like 8. Hosea, like the 8th chapter. Let somebody find that in the law real quick. In Deuteronomy 28. Where it said we're gonna be serving idols.
I know what it said. Like
30.
The Lord said he's gonna lead us into all nations and we're gonna.
I got you right here, Hosea 8:8.
What does that say?
Israel swallowed up.
Yeah.
Hosea 8:8. Israel swallowed up. Now shall they be among the Gentiles as a vessel wherein there is no pleasure.
So Israel was gonna be among all nations. And they're going to be doing the things of the heathen nations. That's why they became that vessel wherein there was no pleasure. All right, they were going to be oppressed. The Lord is going to keep the heathens over us. As long as we were worshiping the creature rather than the creator, man. You know? And that was what was happening throughout those regions, man. Go back to Romans, the first chapter. It says Israel was worshiping the creature more than the creator. And guess what? They were scattered. They were dispersed. They weren't in. That was the children of Israel in Rome.
They wonder why am I miserable when I'm going home? Because of sin, the wages of your sin is death.
Yeah, you can read it real quick. You can 23 maybe.
This is Romans chapter 1 verse 23.
Yeah, 23.
It's Romans chapter 1, verse 23. And change the glory of uncorruptible power into an image made like to corruptible man.
Yeah, Zeus.
Yep.
All right, Jupiter. Who was some of the Roman and Greek idols that they were worshiping back then?
Hades.
Serapis.
Poseidon.
Who was a priest? He was a Christos. All right, a lot of Jake that worship Christ. Serapis was the first Christ, right? He was an image made unto a corruptible man, right? That's an example. So that's what Israelites were doing when they were scattered, you know, amongst the Romans, when they was in Rome, when they was in Corinth, or right, when they was in Galatia, when they was in Ephesus. Okay, that's what that was talking about, man. They were in their ignorance, man. They didn't understand. That's why Paul was sent to them to wake them out of that sleep. Right?
Yep. And Paul has that many letters because that was the important part that Yahweh Shai would do, is he would bring them back into the fold. Yep. That was important because they had fell away from that. And that also had to do with the 10 tribes that wasn't even over in that region no more.
Yep.
That was keeping the other customs or making up the customs as they saw fit over here, the Hispanics and the Native Americans on this side of the world.
Yep. Worshiping owls and cows and all that other stuff.
Yep. Yep. Worshiping the rain gods and so on and so forth.
Yep.
Buffalo.
Yep. Yep. Yeah, go ahead.
Romans chapter 1, verse 23. And change the glory of the uncorruptible power into an image made like to corruptible men, and to birds, and to four-footed beasts, and creeping things. Wherefore the Most High also gave them up to uncleanness through the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves.
That's the point, all right? Because that's what Israel was doing. They were worshiping idols, man.
Yeah.
No different than today. The people on this side, they into all type of idolatry, man.
Why did they start worshiping idols?
But we just went through the history.
I know, but
I'll break it down quickly for you, if it's cool, bro. Basically, when the Greeks came into power, that was the first time that the so-called white people, or the Edomites according to the Bible, came into power. And they had us in captivity at that time, right? So what they did was they made a decree that we should follow after their laws, and or their religion. If we didn't, they would kill us.
How did the Greeks come into power?
Well, they took down the Persians and the Medes before that.
Yeah, you took down history.
The history of it.
Alexander.
So Alexander, well, way before Alexander, right?
Right.
Because you're dealing with Solon and all of them. They took them Solon, and you're dealing with Solon, and you're dealing with Pythagoras and all of them who weren't able to get into those mystery schools.
Okay.
For almost over 20 years, and then somehow got their way into those mystery schools in Egypt, Africa. You know, okay. Stole that stuff.
Okay, but we're talking about the Greeks.
Yeah, the Greeks. That's where the Greeks came from, right? Solon.
No. The Greeks came from Edomites. That's where they came from.
I know they are.
And they call themselves Jews.
But what I'm saying
they call themselves Jews now.
But they're really not Jews. Right. Exactly. Right.
These Greeks, started with their philosophers. Pythagoras,
which was
Solon.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then you get the Aristotle, was the mentor of Alexander the Great.
Right.
At a young age,
right.
When he saw what he did, went in there, stole all the history, right?
Bible study.
Stole all the history, and then he changed the course of history.
Right.
I'm with you guys. He changed the course of history.
Yeah.
And they changed the course of history.
That Library of Alexandria in Egypt.
Yeah.
They got all the books, and they changed up all the course of history.
That's right.
And the scriptures tell you that when these Greeks, when they came into power, wickedness multiplied on the planet Earth.
Right.
All right, they multiplied on the planet Earth, you know, and they were responsible for why our people became Gentiles in the New Testament.
We were never
the New Testament, the Bible.
All the Gentiles are European.
Well, that's what we're going into right now.
Right.
You had in the New Testament the people that the Lord sent Apostle Paul to. Those Gentiles were actual Israelites, but they had lost their heritage because they were in captivity under the Greeks and the Romans.
Well, Paul was called to preach the gospel to the Gentiles.
That's
and if you read everywhere in scripture, you will not find Paul preaching the gospel anywhere else, nowhere but in European nations.
Okay.
Because he preached the gospel. Which is Turkey and all that. Yeah.
Right.
Now.
We was in them nations.
True. That's true.
That's who we went to go preach to.
I agree. I agree with everything y'all saying, but the only thing I am saying is this, though. If you read Genesis right, and this is what it said when his sons were Japheth. He had three sons, Ham, Shem, and Japheth.
Right.
Ham made up your Jewish nation, which Abraham and them. I know, but I'm just saying the way the Bible
goes. Yeah, I got it.
Then you got Ham, then you got Shem, and Japheth. When he said Japheth generation, after he named all their kin people and all their children and their heirs, this is what it said. It said, now, these are the heirs, these are the lands of the Gentiles. All Gentile people come from Japheth, the son of Ham.
Right.
Okay.
Son of Ham.
Because that's been misunderstood in the Bible, and that's what we've been missing.
Let me explain. There's 18 nations on the planet, right?
Yeah.
All the other 17 nations are heathens or Gentiles, meaning outside, not the people of Israel.
You got natural Gentiles, and then you have
spiritual Gentiles, which are the Israelites. Yes, we're explaining it to you, sir. We're explaining you what it is. The context of what it is.
Like this.
You got it right here. Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. That's perfect.
This is right.
But watch this. But you do not see nobody but Europeans here. You got it right here.
You got it right.
Y'all think y'all need to go back and you got it right here. Whoever did this did it right.
Hold on, Jay.
Check it out.
Yeah, look right here. You got it right.
We got it all right.
Okay, but you can't jump up here and go to Ham and say and put him in that. Because we never was Gentiles.
We was in them places.
How can you be
Gentiles?
No, bro, that's where y'all missing it at.
This is why we're missing our heritage.
I'm trying to show you.
Okay, check this out. Check this out. Listen to this.
You got it. Whoever did this did it correct.
Check this out. I'm going to ask you this.
You see, you got it right here.
I'm going to ask you this. Listen to this, though, bro.
Where's Moses?
Listen to this. Check this out.
Whoever did that got it right.
Listen to this, bro. Check this out.
This is what we're missing our heritage when we try to break the
system. Listen to this, sir.
Okay.
Right now you're in America, right?
I understand it, yeah.
What do you call yourself being here in America?
What I call myself?
Yeah, what is your heritage?
I'm a Jew.
Okay. Most people don't know that, right?
I'm an Israelite.
Most people don't know that,
I know that, right. So that's why I ain't disagreeing with you.
What are those people that do not know, our people that do not know calling themselves?
Let me show it to you.
Hold on. You got to ask the questions first, bro. And then I'm going to break it down.
I'll let you do that. But what I'm saying.
You got to ask the question.
I don't call myself that. I'm asking you a question like you asked. I'm asking your question just like you asked me to.
Yeah.
You told me what do they call themselves. Okay. I don't call myself that because I know better.
Okay.
But hold it. But now they do. That's why we all are missing it.
What do those people here in America, our people, call themselves?
The one that don't know no better.
They don't know no better. What they call
exactly
themselves?
What I've been saying. This right here is what they've been calling themselves.
They've been calling
African American.
They call themselves black.
I'm not African American.
The word Gentile. Let's deal with this Gentile in Genesis the 10th chapter.
Okay.
The word Gentile for that word in the Hebrew is from the Hebrew word goyim. Goyim.
Okay.
And it means non-Hebrew nations.
Bingo! Yes, I agree with that.
Ham is not right. is not of the Israelite stock.
Not only him.
Japheth is not of the Israelite stock.
He's not either.
Esau is not of the Israelite stock.
That's the only one you got.
Anybody that's not of Israelites are goyim.
Okay.
They're goyim.
And you call them
what? They're Gentiles.
Bingo. Let me break this down.
You're saying that Japheth is the Gentile.
He's the father. That's right. The Bible tells you that.
How is he the father?
It says it. Go in there and look. He go through every.
Go to Genesis 10.
All right, right. He said he. Let me read.
Let's see if it says that.
I'm gonna make sense.
He's called.
I'm gonna make sense.
From what nation is Abraham called?
Abraham came from Shem. We can rest that. Right here.
Because Abram is called from what nation?
Right here.
Shem. He comes from where?
Shem.
But it comes out of...
Watch the camera, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry.
He comes from Shem.
But what country did he come from?
He come from the land of Ur and the Chaldeans.
Exactly.
So Ur and the
Chaldeans. He was a moon worshiper.
What?
Abraham was a moon worshiper.
Where did Ur and the Chaldeans and where did all them migrating come from?
Well, we all was together before the Tower of Babel.
They were all there.
And then we all were separated.
You had Ham, and then who was his son?
You talking about Canaan? The Canaanites?
You got Canaan.
Yeah, of course.
And you got who?
You got
Canaan, Mithraim, Cush, and Put.
You have Put.
Put was Libya. Okay. Cush was Mithraim.
And
was,
where did all
was,
them
right. Cush was Ethiopia.
That part's right also.
Where did they all spread out?
They spread out into the African nations.
The point
so where does Abraham really come from?
Abraham came. He did his journey. He did his journey all the way from the land of Ur. And he came down into the promised land.
But remember, you got to remember this too, though. In the Bible, if you don't understand the Masoret text, you gonna get all that messed up.
The Gentiles what got everybody screwed up. That's why we live by black people.
You understand the ellipsis, right?
Let's have order. Let's deal with this man in the Gentile thing.
Okay. Now you know you're a Jew, right?
Yeah.
But before you knew you was a Jew, what was you calling yourself?
American, African American.
You were a Gentile.
Just like everybody
then.
Else. Until I got.
That's the Gentile.
No, that's not true.
Yes, that's the Gentile.
That is not true.
Read that, man.
Let me break this down. Let me break it down. Watch this. Here's really what a Gentile is. A Gentile is a person, really, where God had never been. God went to us first.
So let me back it up. Let me put it in context.
Because there's a couple of different Greek words for the word Gentile in the Bible.
But you got it on your own poster here.
I know.
It ain't but three.
The poster's right.
Listen, it's perfect.
I know.
But y'all are contradicting your own culture.
How are we contradicting?
Pull the poster back out.
But when you go to also
pull the poster back out.
Do you believe in the Bible?
Let me show you.
What's your Greek, man?
He cannot be a Gentile because God already came to them first. God dealt with us. Jesus came.
No.
How could you even? How are you saying that's dealing with us when you claim to be a Jew?
God, we're not.
What I'm saying is, when God separated the languages, they said they all of us basically. We went into, and then you got Sam went into the Middle Eastern country. Ham went into the African nation and into Israel, which were the Canaanites. Canaanites went into Israel. Then you got Japheth, who make up your European. That is right there. Japheth make up your European. If you read in this Bible right here, let me finish. Exactly.
Before the white man came.
Exactly. If you read in your Bible right here, it will tell you. Now, after he named every one of Japheth's children, it says, now these are the owls of the Gentiles.
No, it did not say that.
Read it. I want you to read it.
Let me tell you, the most misconstrued, what messed us up, what really got the white folk messed up more than anybody.
Well, we don't really understand our heritage and our history is that one word. If we get Gentile right, you'll get it all right. We are missing it by that one word. I keep saying it, I preach it, I teach it.
We know
that Gentile word.
We know every word Gentile in the scripture, the original language of it.
Yeah, but let me say that. And you said it right.
Yeah, that's it.
But
there's no more to say after that, sir.
But like what you just like what you just told me just a few minutes ago.
You said it's returning just to Japheth.
It said he named all their children, and then at the end it said, now these are the isles of the Gentiles.
Read it and then jump to Ham. Those are the islands that they're scattered out.
I want you to read it right here.
So you get mixed up because
of the English.
Genesis 10, I'm going to start at 3. And the sons of Gomer, Ashkenaz, Riphathah,
sons of Japheth,
Tamar,
yep.
the sons of Javan, Ishmael,
which is Greek,
till you and Tarnish,
right, that's Tarnish,
in Greek, Hebrew, Chaldean, and Aramaic. You will never understand.
Why these were the isles of the Gentiles divided in their lands,
and in their nation,
after their tongue,
and in their nation,
after their families and nations.
I'm very well versed.
But this is it.
The word nations. Hold on. What is the word nation? What does the word nations mean? What does the word nations mean? What does the word nations mean? What does the word nations mean?
You just said it.
What is the word nations mean?
Brother, y'all go
what
back
is that in the Hebrew?
Your man
what
right
is that in the Hebrew?
Wait, hold on.
What is it in the Hebrew?
Hold on.
You just said
you want to answer the question.
Nobody ever wants to answer that question.
See, the word Gentile. Let's go back into the word Gentile.
Did we get that right?
What is it in the Hebrew?
We're going to miss it.
What is it in the Hebrew? What is the word Gentile? What is it in the Hebrew? I'm talking about the Genesis. I'm talking about the Genesis.
Don't know
the original.
If you don't understand.
Dude, what is that name? The Old Testament was written in Hebrew,
right?
So and then it was translated into that word, right? So that word.
You tell me.
That word.
You don't know. You tell me.
I told you. I thought you was listening.
I don't know. What is
you so quick to get your point out, you're not even listening.
What is it?
I broke it down to you.
What is it?
The word there for Gentile is from the Hebrew word goyim or gawayim, which means foreign nation.
Okay, right. And he just read it when he said, be the nation.
And when you go into
Ham, nation.
When you go into the Ham, that same word is accounted for Ham.
No, it isn't. You going in a whole other chapter.
Get it. Bro.
You going to a whole other chapter.
Keep reading down.
Ham, the descendants. Genesis 10 and 6.
But you don't see
and these and the sons of Ham, Cush and Mizraim and Put and Canaan. And the sons of Cush, Sheba.
But man, I'm just glad to see y'all on.
Jump to 20. Get 20. Oh, we finna get it.
I'm gonna tell y'all.
Jump 20. I'm gonna be frank.
Don't let them white folks
family,
tell y'all about them Gentiles. That's what's screwing everything up.
Let me tell you something.
The white folk got y'all messed up.
Let me tell you something. Hold on. Let me tell you something, sir.
White folk got y'all messed up.
He don't have respect for the word, man.
Let me say something. Hold on. Let me ask you a question right quick. Time out, sir. Let me ask you something. Do you think we're out here with no knowledge of what's going on?
I told you.
Do you think we're just out here dressed like this, that you've never seen this before? Let me ask my full question, please, sir. Please let me ask my full question.
Go ahead.
That we didn't do the deep research necessary to bring this word out in its proper context, in its proper spirit. If we're out here on the Las Vegas Strip in Sin City, if we didn't know that stuff.
Let me say this.
Any man walking up and down the street could just come and just confound us.
No.
You think that's what we're out here? Sir, you think the Heavenly Father didn't send us out here?
Let me say
do you think the Heavenly Father didn't send us out here and didn't arm us with all the proper...
Let me finish, sir.
And didn't arm us with all the proper things that we need to talk about anything? The thing you don't understand, sir, is we know all of this and we're trying to enlighten you on the part that you don't know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let me say this.
You wouldn't listen to what I said.
He said,
let your yea be yea and your nay nay.
He said, but one thing I do. He said, I have not yet apprehended. In other words, what Paul was saying, I don't know everything in Scripture. I don't know everything about the Bible. I don't know it all. Even Jesus said himself, these 66 books cannot contain me. But you telling me, y'all know it all.
Yes.
That's what you're saying.
Yes. Know why? You want to know why?
Because we got the unction.
Right.
You know why? Because the Heavenly Father gave it to us. That's why. Just because you didn't get it, G-Man, just because you didn't get it, don't get jealous, bro. The Heavenly Father gave it to us, man.
Why you fussing?
So we're trying to give you something, and you're fighting against us giving you the truth.
Okay.
We're trying to give you the truth, but you don't want it.
What's the true name of the Heavenly Father?
Okay.
That's the simple question.
Like I said, we have a matter of opinion that you see.
This ain't opinion no more,
okay? Okay, you have it in opinion.
This ain't opinion no more. This is of the Heavenly Father.
It's one truth.
We're bringing this straight out the Heavenly Father. It's the truth.
We understand that. But what I'm saying is this. We have one situation here that we disagree on. Everything else that y'all said, I agree with. I didn't agree with
everything. We can bring you to the understanding of the
one that
you
can't even receive that.
No, you can't just make me receive what you believe because that's what you believe.
Can two walk together?
I got the source up. I got the source.
Amen.
I got the source. We dealing with the Bible here.
I got the source.
Oh, okay.
So you got it.
So I got the same.
Let G-Man
I'm talking about.
Second.
I'm talking about to make them heaven and earth, the creator.
All right.
I have him too, just like you say you do.
Okay, what's the name of the Heavenly Father? What's the name of the Heavenly Father and his son?
What is it in Hebrew?
If thou canst tell.
No, you can't tell me.
You tell me.
I know what it is.
It ain't even. All right, I'm going to tell you this, then you're going to know I know.
Go ahead.
It ain't even a J in the Hebrew
language. We know that.
We know the name. We know the word.
What do you call him?
I asked you that question.
I already know.
I call him Jesus. So I asked you.
I was saying what he said.
I asked you.
Tell me what you call him.
I asked you.
I already know.
What is it? What is it?
It's not Jesus.
We know. We know that.
You tell me.
Now you want to know.
Bro.
I thought you were going to say,
the same thing.
You know what it's like to say? Son profane babbling.
Hey, babbling. We're young men, right?
You babbling.
You're clearly older than us, right? Right?
Than me, at least, right?
Than me.
We're defending the gospel.
That's what I'm saying. Then why are you playing games, though?
Why you showed me
that? I'm trying to give you the word of the Heavenly Father.
You know what the
word of respect means?
That's what attorney does. He don't ask no questions. He don't know the answer.
Because you are too old to be playing all these damn games, man. Salvation is on the line. You playing game? Oh, cuz. A grown man worried about me saying damn game.
But man.
Hey, Jake is
this
lost,
young man can say that. Busted yours, crack to him in Hebrew. Go ahead.
I understand it. I mean, go ahead.
So the other one pull out is a. Abunau Shabashamayam Kodash Haya Shamka Yahweh Malakutka Tabaa Ratazaka Haya Ishaba Ratazaka Wa Haya Bashamayam Natanga Nawa Lakam Kabawat Nawa Kasalak Nawa Wasalak Nawa Kabawatya Nawa Wala A Tabaya Nawa Banasaya Wam Abo Hawashai Nawa Mayan Raikaya Laka Hamalakwat Waha Allah Wala Thai Parak Lai Wala Mayam Ama.
Now, do you really think we up here and don't know what we doing?
We never said anything like
that. And this the youngest man here.
I mean, I don't do all that. All my thing is, unless you understand the Masoretic, the Greek, the Hebrew, understand figures
of
speech,
etymology of words,
understand the etymology of words,
you're
never going to understand. But you never argue with a person on that point. Remember,
if a person is
offended, you defend it as an attorney. Right, right. But when you get...
Like he said, what was it, the Babylon?
Babylon. Right. We had to let him go. I had to give him that.
You let a person just be.
Right.
Let them be.
Let the ignorant be ignorant.
This is for edification of those that's
I mean, it's all life.
And when people come to address us, hey, we got a job here. You know what I'm saying?
I understand.
That's what we out here.
We could be, if we were just regular men, we would be doing something more fun with our Saturday or Sunday weekend.
I get it. My thing is, you know, I just want to see us as black folks.
We're Israelite.
I hear you. I get where you're going with everything.
You gotta break that paradigm.
I get where the white man placed that paradigm. Trust that.
No, I'm saying that concept of
Paradigms, he placed that on all people.
Because when he made us black, he made himself white. Which
is I tell people, we know who that is. We know who that picture is.
The so-called white man, let's say
we know who the picture is. We know the Roman Pope who put his son up there, you know, and gives us the picture.
We know that picture. Check this out. Everybody don't know that.
You know who that picture is.
Yeah, we know Caesar Cusser, but check this out.
All right,
Everybody don't know this. My man. The people that don't know,
those
are no Gentiles today. They don't know who they are. That's what we was trying to tell us, bro. He believes he's a Jew.
But he believes that we have mites.
Well, that don't make any sense.
What they don't understand is that those who call themselves Jews over there now are heathens. They come from Amalek.
Well, they come from
Khazar.
That's what they come from.
Which means Caucasus Mountains.
and the time back to Edomites, man.
Bro, we ain't out here, you know. I feel you. I'm not trying to say that to you like that.
Now, here's my thing. The reason I say it is because in my young age,
right?
All right? And when you come from a family like that, and then I went to seminary, I have a degree in all of it. But see, I didn't pussyfoot around. I dug, and I got in there. And when you dig and you get in there and you begin to discover who you are, nobody can use that as a weapon against you. And when you discover who you are, I don't care if you call yourself a black man, Hebrew, whatever, white, ain't nobody gonna tell me who I am, whom's I am, and who I can become, because I know who I am.
Hey, that goes back to when we opened up earlier, we was talking about how this white man is starting to get nervous because now the true Israelites are waking up to who they are. And these devils can't tell us who we are.
Well, did not he say that? And now we woke up. Did not he tell us that he would, what, Israel? What is it? Was it in Isaiah?
Where he would
wake us up and
the valley of the dry bones?
Not the valley of the dry bones.
But that's
dealing with one of them.
Send Elijah the prophet.
Dealing with a symbol that the outcasts of Israel, the dispersed of Judah.
Yeah.
You know, you got the northern tribes. Everything is being brought back, man.
So let me say this to you, bro. Mm-hmm. If, just to say it, so it ain't weighing on my spirit, or the Heavenly Father don't get upset with me because we didn't say it.
Right.
You knowing that about yourself in the Bible, you gotta try to do your best to keep these statutes off the commandments, meaning off the top of the beard. You gotta keep that beard and stop doing that lineup, bro. I'm just saying, if that's your job, that's the thing of the Gentiles. That goes back to the Gentiles.
Right. The thing that the Gentiles did.
You gotta do the best you can do. Now, I'm gonna say this. Like, if it's a job, that's one thing, but I gotta tell you that you're not saved by the law, but your faith is shown by practicing the law.
Yes,
to the best of your ability.
The law itself ain't gonna save you, but you want to practice the law, you know.
Shows the faith. I understand it, but remember, it's faith. It was counted unto Abraham righteousness.
That's right.
Because he believed.
Without the deed of the law.
Not all of that other stuff you talk about.
That's true.
But, okay.
But
hold on. Be eating pork.
I understand. I understand. Okay. I understand all that.
Shrimp, crawfish, and all that.
And there's also other things you can't be doing,
yeah,
too.
Well, I'm just saying.
I see many of these in this. You know what I'm saying?
But when you do those
there's a lot of other things, too. There's a lot of other things, too. Let me ask you this question also. Remember this. Like, I dealt with a pastor one time. He was dealing with a girl and all this other stuff. He keeps talking about the law and all this stuff like this. Again, we are what? Accepted by God because of what? Faith. It is what? It is impossible to please him. That word is a strong word.
11 and 6, right?
And then you got to understand certain things in the book. If it's an imperative, is it something that's not an imperative? I'm pretty sure y'all understand. Okay. So you gotta understand if it's an imperative. And then it's by faith. Mm-hmm. It's faith where God is going. That's the only thing with Abraham. It was faith. You had David, womanizer.
Even Abraham still had to show.
He lied a lot.
He still had to show that he was.
Who lied? Are you talking about the thing with the Egyptian? Is that what
you know he lied about?
He said about the
sister. About the sister?
He lied
about the sister.
Come on, man.
He lied.
You know what the word? You know what the word Jacob? He's Jacob, a trickster.
He's a trickster.
Right.
And then he got his name changed.
He had that same kind of.
Because he said, I'm not going to leave until you bless me. He wrestled with God all night.
You do that.
And I'm not going. You can wrestle with it. And I'm not going to leave until you bless me. And then for the hollow. Or what was it? His thigh?
He broke his hip.
And then
right.
His name is changed to what? Israel. One who does what?
It means prince of God.
One who does what with God, though? Strives, wrestles.
They were tussling, you know?
Yeah. Now, you get the. I always ask this question.
Just a quick question. I'm just a white guy that's a Catholic believer that just wants to know your.
Beautiful. That we've been getting that Christian Edomites all day.
But this is coming out of the positivity of my heart. Believe me, it's coming right from my soul. Why would you do this, first of all? And second of all, what's your biggest value?
Before you ask that question, you're going to be here to receive this answer? Put that cigarette out.
Please.
Well, you know what? I really don't want to put this cigarette out right now. Well, okay, well, fair enough. It really, it was a quick answer. It was a quick question. It was a quick answer. You guys could have gave it to me very easily and very nicely.
But we just
left
now. Right.
You want something that you don't want to give us now.
We want help. Yeah.
Right.
That's you, Esau.
Well,
it's a cigarette. Well, we didn't say throw it away. We said put it out and relight when you walk.
Well, you're in Las Vegas, and wherever fucking centimeter that you walk into, you're gonna start blowing fucking cigarettes.
Then we don't have an answer for you.
So
have a nice day. Peace. Have a nice day.
That's Esau.
You don't want to
know everything. We don't want to give up shit.
He don't want. He didn't want to really get that answer.
Because
he had an answer. He said y'all could have gave me a quick answer. He said you could have gave me the quick answer.
We know.
That means you know what you really want to hear.
We're not going to think.
That's right.
No, we're going to read the scripture.
Keep spreading light.
You know you're an Israelite, right? So you understand that.
That's why
you know the Lord coming back, right?
I understand it very
well. All right, bro. Anyway, we custom like this.
And remember, Yeshua, remember. Yeshua. We know.
That's not his name.
We know what they say, Yeshua.
No, there's no you in the Hebrew.
Well, there's no you. There's no J. There's no J.
That old cat, he didn't want to get to that because he didn't really get to that.
He already dealt with his con.
What would you would have called him?
No, we know what his name is.
That's what I'm saying.
What
it means.
You called him what?
I will just give it.
What would you call
him? The Heavenly Father's name is Yahweh.
Okay.
I mean, in the ancient Hebrew, the Tetragrammaton supports that, right? Which Yah is He, and Yahweh is. Right, or he exists, right?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Now, the son of the father's name is Yahweh Shai, which is he is deliverer, he is savior. The same thing.
And this story was all first told in the stars, right?
Yeah, in the heavens. When all
it was
this
all was told in the what? In the, they in call the ancient, it the, Kalashman what do they call it? They call it the
firmament.
They call it the,
you're talking about
the oral tradition.
Right.
The oral tradition.
Passing
the
oral.
Before Moses, it was passed.
The story was told in the constellations.
Well, we're not. We don't want to teach that because that had something to do with it. But we don't want to teach that. But we don't want to teach that because people will go into astrology. Yeah.
Well,
and stop going into what this is about.
Well, you know, you even got Job who spoke of things in astrology. But
right.
The way we see astrology today is not how they saw it.
Yeah. Right.
It's been messed up.
Astrology and astronomy. We don't want our people getting caught up in that, or even numerology.
I was just about to say it.
We don't want them caught up in that. We want them caught up in what
the
word is about faith and trying to do the best that this.
My thing is, I always say this: without faith, it's impossible.
Right.
It was accounted Abraham righteous, right standard.
You show me. You show me your
works.
Yeah, hey. And you show me your show me your faith, and I will show you my faith.
I always tell people, let me see your results in what you do.
This is
our results.
We're doing
our
faith.
Faith.
I'm about to worship
God. We're doing sacrifice. We're out here on the highways and byways.
Every week,
where y'all from? Our lives,
we live here. Now.
From here now,
we live here.
We don't know who we're gonna encounter. Hey, we didn't have to have fights with niggas. Yep. All kinds of shit. We out here doing it. Ain't none of them preachers in the church gonna come out here and to do what we do. None of them.
That's right.
But
they ain't got the nerve.
Our faith that the Heavenly Father deal with us because we've been out here for years now.
They don't have the faith to do it.
Ain't no preacher going to condemn the white man in his own kingdom.
Right.
And telling him he going into slavery.
Okay.
Yep.
They ain't going to do
that's
it.
That
preacher you just seen who teach, he ain't going to do it.
Or
why he not out here.
I'm going to say it this way. I'm going to say it harshly like this for a reason. Or condemn a nigga to his face.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Knowing what niggas do, gangster niggas, thug niggas, whatever, knowing what they do, how they get down, how they operate, us knowing that, we still condemn them too, showing faith unto the Heavenly Father.
The angels encamped around the ones that fear the Lord.
Right, that's
it. But I'm just saying, all of that. My whole thing is,
you're right, without
faith.
It's
accounted Abraham righteousness.
The church shall live by
faith. We could not do this.
Gone.
Without faith, we couldn't come out here and do this.
All right. Our faith is a gift.
But
we don't walk by sight, but by faith.
A so-called garment on, people calling it a dress, you got to.